فؤادك الأيام فتى.
That the Hajj and the Jihad and the Jum'ah, the Friday's congregations, and the A'yad, the Eid celebration, all of them are done with who? Ma'al Umara'i, the leaders. Abraran kanu, whether they are righteous ones, aw fujara, or whether they are transgressors. Pay attention, lakin, this is the istithla, you have to remember. If the leader embarks on a Jihad which is not mashru', it's not a legislated Jihad, and he goes and he wants to fight, because he has a gharad, and he wants to do it for himself. Are you with me? Person, he wants to go there. Are you with me? Or the leader is known for what? He's known for his what? His khiyana, he's deceitful. He takes the Muslim to the battlefield and he will leave them there. Something like that. Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah ta'ala and Ahlul Sunnah are mujmi'un, unanimous in agreement that he's not obeyed. And it falls under the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, لا طاعة لمخلوق في معصية الخالق. The ruler is obeyed as long as he's what? As long as it's from the Sharia. Pay attention. That particular thing, if the leader orders you not to pray and to come to him, and he ordered, prohibits you from praying, you don't obey him on that, you pray. And then after that, if he asks you to do something for him which is permissible, you have to obey him in it. The disobedience is in that particular thing, faqat. Why? Because it goes against the religion of Allah. It goes against the religion of Allah. You don't obey him in that. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he told us in a hadith, and Imam al-Bukhari and Muslim, min hadith Abdullah ibn Abbas, that the Prophet said, مَنْ رَأَى مِنْ أَمِيرِهِ شَيْئًا يَكْرَهُ. Anyone who sees from his leader something which he dislikes of him, فَلْيَصْبِرْ عَلَيْهِ. Be patient on it. فَإِنَّهُ مَنْ خَرَجَ مِنَ الْجَمَاعَةِ. Because anyone who leaves that group, anyone who leaves the unity of the Muslims upon that leader, فَمَاتَ, and then he dies, شِبْرًا, just one hand span, he cuts off. He says, you know what, I'm not going to live in the city anymore. Just one span, he moves out of the city. Are you with me? He moves away. فَمَاتَ, and he dies. إِلَّا مَاتَ مِيتَةً جَاهِلِيَّةً. That person will die the death of jahiliyyah. In another wording, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said what? فَقَدْ خَلَعَ رِقْبَةَ الْإِسْلَامِ مِنْ عُنُقِي. He has taken Islam from his neck. He's taken it out. Meaning, he's upon the path of Ahlul Jahiliyyah. Ahlul Jahiliyyah were one who what? That they had no bay'ah on nobody's neck. They used to just be free. That's the way you become. You see? And also the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to take bay'ah, pledge of allegiance with the people regarding this. He used to take pledge of allegiance with them. Ubadah ibn Usamah narrated in Sahih al-Bukhari. Ubadah ibn Bukhari al-Muslim. He said, bay'ana Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the Prophet took pledge of allegiance with us. On what? Ala sam'i wa ta'ah, that we will listen to the leader and that we will obey him. Fil usri wal yusr, times of ease and times of hardship. Wal manshat wal makra. Wa an la nunazza' al amr ahlahu. And that we will never wrestle and argue with the ruler in terms of his authority. We'll never. Except when, إِلَّا أَن تَرَوْا كُفْرًا بَوَاحًا. Unless you see clear-cut kufr. What did the hadith say? You hear? Did he say, well, you hear kufr from him? Or you read it on a paper? إِلَّا أَن تَرَوْا. You see it with your own eyes. Not through Facebook, not through YouTube. You go and you see it with your eyes. إِلَّا أَن تَرَوْا. You see it. Aynan, with your eyes. Not a maqala, a letter that's written. You don't know who wrote it, when it was written, how it was written. You see it with your eyes. Illa an taraw. You have to underline that. Kufr, what type of kufr? Kufran bawah. A clear-cut kufr. A kufr that everybody agrees. A matter which people are disputing whether it's kufr or not. Some are saying it is kufr, some are saying no, it's not. How are you going to do it? It's muhtamal. The matter is what? It's unclear. It has to be kufr bawah. The Prophet didn't just say that. He went on to say, ma'akum min Allahi fihi burhan. With you regarding this is an evidence in front of Allah. If Allah asks you, why did you go against him? Why did you take your hand out? You can be able. Now, and the things that fall under this, and that we're going to speak about it in the upcoming point, is the matters of khuruj, going against the leader and getting your hand out of him. Now.
وَلَا نَرَى خُرُوجَ عَلَى الْأَئِمَّةِ وَلَا الْقِتَالَ فِي الْفِتْنَةِ ونسمع ونطيع لمن ولاه الله عز وجل أمرنا ولا ننزع يدا من طاعة ونتبع السنة والجماعة ونجتنب الشذوذ والخلاف والفرقة.
Here the author is talking about the issue of what? حكم الخروج على ولاة الأمر. Going against the leader of the Muslims, a person who's leading the Muslims. عقيدة أهل السنة والجماعة, based on the ayah in Surah An-Nisa, ayah 59, Allah says, يا أيها الذين آمنوا those of you who believe in Allah, أطيعوا الله, obey Allah, وأطيعوا الرسول, obey the messenger, وأولي الأمر منكم, and obey the people who have authority over you, obey them. And also the hadith of Ubadah ibn Samit, which I just narrated. This matter of obeying the ruler is not a matter that started yesterday or the day before. You can see Abu Hatim al-Razi is mentioning this in his book. Ahlul Sunnati, before, they brought evidences for this before. For example, go to Sahih Muslim. Al-Imam Muslim, he has a whole chapter called what? Kitab al-Imara. Imam Muslim, rahimahullah ta'ala, he has a whole kitab in the Sahih. He called it what? Kitab al-Imara. He talks about, he brings his evidences. Go to Kitab al-Fitan wal-Ahkam in Sahih al-Bukhari. And Imam al-Bukhari brings it. Go to Kitab al-Sunnah in Imam Abi Dawood in his Sunan. He brings a kitab called Kitab al-Sunan. Ama Kitab al-Sunnah. He talks about it there. All these narrations are there. Go to the Muqaddimah, the introduction of Sunan ibn Majah. There are evidences there that talk about this. There are books that are written about this issue explicitly. Al-Imam al-Shatibi, his Kitab al-I'tisam. He talks about this issue very well. Go to Al-Ibanat al-Sughra, Ibanat al-Kubra by Ibn Battah. He wrote that. Go to Sharh al-Sunnah by Abu Qasim, Hibatullah ilalaka'i. Go to Al-Sharia, Al-Imam al-Ajurri, Rahimahullah. And other than those books I have mentioned, you will find adilla. Dalatun ala ma dhakarna. That mention that which we have said. Which is what? That the ruler, you don't go against him. Imam Ahmad in his Usul al-Sunnah, look what he said. He said, وَمَنْ خَرَجَ عَلَىٰ إِمَامٍ مِنْ أَيْمَةِ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. Anyone who goes against an imam from the أَيْمَةِ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. وَقَدْ كَانَ النَّاسُ اجْتَمَعُوا عَلَيْهِ. And the people have come together regarding this person. They all came and they united on him. وَأَقَرُّوا لَهُ بِالْخِلَافَةِ. And they've all affirmed for him that he's a khalifatul al-Muslimin. Look at this point that he mentioned. The khalifa can't just be somebody who just popped out from nowhere, or there's nobody who gave it to him. The issue of khilafa is what? وَأَقَرُّوا لَهُ. The people are all in agreement that this person is a khalifa. Who's saying this? Imam Uman? Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal. The people are united on his khilafa. They all agree. بِأَيِّ وَجْهٍ كَانَ. It doesn't matter how this man came into khilafa. If he even came forcefully, غَلَبَ, and the people all united again, they said, you know what, he's strong, what can we do? And he's a fasiq. He's a fasiq. We don't like him. He takes over. And the people are forcefully adhering to him because he's got power over them. Every corner he's got army there. Has he got power over the people? Ahlul Sunnah believe that? You're not allowed to what? You see, ala بِأَيِّ وَجْهٍ كَانَ بِالرِّضَى أَوْ بِالْغَلَبَةِ. He's mentioned it to you. Whether it's بِالرِّضَى, you're pleased with him. بَيْعَ, the way it went through Ahlul Halli wal Aqd, they unite. No, he is not. غَلَبَة, forcefully he came. فَقَدْ شَقَّ هَذَا الْخَارِجُ أَسَى الْمُسْلِمِينَ. The one who goes against him, he has cut off from the Muslims. وَخَالَفَ الْآثَارَ. And he has gone against the text. عَلْ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ, from the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم. فَإِنْ مَاتَ, if that person dies. فَإِنْ مَاتَ الْخَارِجُ, that one who went against the leader, if he dies. مَاتَ مِيتَةً جَاهِلِيَةً, he will die the death of a jahiliyyah. وَلَا يَحِلُّ قِتَالَ السُّلْطَانِ. It is not permissible to fight against the leader. وَلَا الْخُرُوجِ عَلَيْهِ, and it's not permissible to go against him. لِأَحْدِ مِنَ النَّاسِ, not for anybody from the people. فَمَنْ فَعَلَ ذَلِكَ, anyone who does that. فَهُوَ مُبْتَدِعٌ, he's an innovator. عَلَى غَيْرِ السُنَّةِ, on other than the path of the Prophet ﷺ. You see what tariq. Imam Muhammad said this in his Usul al-Sunnah. And when we study that book, we will go into more details. The khuruj, going against the ruler, is two types. Ha. وَالْخُرُوجُ يَنْقَسِمُ إِلَىٰ قِسْمَيْنِ. It's two types. The first khuruj is what? خُرُوجُ بِالْفِعْلِ وَالْقِتَالِ. The person takes his weapons, he walks out, and he says, let's fight. Let's take this guy down. That's لا يجوز. The second type is what? الخروج بالقول والتأليب والإثارة على ذلك الإمام. The second one is what? Going against him by speech. Going against him by what? By speech. By telling the people, this ruler, subhanAllah, look what he does. So unjust. And you do إثارة, you bring the people up, and you rise the people. Demonstration, all of that falls under here. Demonstration, all of it is here. You're not allowed to go against him. لماذا? Why? Because when the Prophet used the word خروج, the word is مطلق. For you to say that's only fi'l, for you to specify and to say it's only action, and that the speech doesn't fall under it, or mudaharat and demonstration doesn't fall under it, فَعَلَيْكَ بِالدَّلِيلِ, bring evidence for it. What do you have to bring? Evidence. Demonstration rather is not from the religion. It is from the sunan al-kufar. It's the method, the parts of the kufar. Muslims haven't done this. But inshallah ta'ala, we will speak about it in more details in another episode or another sit. What the hukum of mudaharat is. نعم.
ونجتنب الشذوذ والخلاف والفرقة.
So we, and we, the author also mentions here what? ونجتنب, we stay away from الشذوذ والخلافة والفرقة. We also stay away from what? We stay away from شذوذ. شذوذ is what? It is to cut off. شذوذ means you stand by yourself, a person who shadh. والخلاف, dispute, we stay away from it. Al-Sunnah don't do that. We don't like that. Imam Tahawi said the same wording. He said, وَنَتَّبِعُ السُّنَّةَ وَالْجَمَاعَةَ وَنَجْتَنِبُ الشُّذُوذُ وَالْخِلَافُ وَالْفُرْقَةَ. Al-Sunnah, look at the words, they look the same and the way they speak. We are with the jama'ah, we're with the ummah. We don't cut off, we don't stand alone. Na'am. We don't. The khilaf that's been spoken about is the haqq. We follow the sunnah. And by following the sunnah, if the ummah are following the sunnah, we stay with the ummah. Are you with me? We stay with the ummah. But if the ummah have gone against the sunnah, وَهُمْ فِي وَادٍ, they are in a valley. وَالسُنَّةُ فِي وَادٍ, and the sunnah is on another valley, نَحْنُ مَعَ السُنَّةِ, we're with the sunnah. نَعَمْ, we're with the sunnah. But we mean that there's Muslims are united upon the haqq. They are also united upon a leader. They've all united on this leader. We don't cut off and say, I don't like this leader, I want to make my own leader. And we bring groups and groups and groups and groups, like, we stay with this. We stay with the leader. We stay with this leader who's leading the Muslims. Na'am. And we don't cut off. Na'am. The jama'ah is what? The jama'ah is the haqq. The jama'ah is the what? Al-Imam al-Shatibi in his Kitab al-I'tisam, which I again advise all of you to go to, he mentions that the jama'ah, that word, it takes five meanings. Five different meanings. When jama'ah is said, what is meant by it? Al-Imam al-Shatibi in his Kitab al-I'tisam, he has a good research on that issue. And the evidence for not going against it is وَلَا تَكُونُوا مِنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ مِنَ الَّذِينَ فَرَّقُوا دِينَهُمْ وَكَانُوا شِيعًا كُلُّ حِزْبٍ بِمَا لَدَيْهِمْ فَرِحُونَ. You see, we were ordered not to do that. Also Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he said, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ فَرَّقُوا دِينَهُمْ وَكَانُوا شِيعًا لَسْتَ مِنْهُمْ فِي شَيْءٍ إِنَّمَا أَمُرُهُمْ إِلَى اللَّهِ ثُمَّ يُنَبِّئُهُمْ بِمَا كَانُوا يَفْعَلُونَ. Also Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he said, شَرَعَ لَكُمْ مِنَ الدِّينِ مَا وَصَّى بِهِ نُوحًا وَالَّذِي أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْكَ كَمَا وَصَّيْنَا بِإِبْرَاهِيمَ وَمُوسَى وَعِيسَى أَنْ أَقِيمُوا الدِّينَ وَلَا تَتَفَرَّقُوا فِيهِ. Allah told, and establish the religion and do not disperse and do not cut off from one another. نعم. One point I didn't mention before, which is important as well, is one of the things that fall under the khuruj, as I said, demonstration is. Demonstration falls under khuruj. And also what falls under it is at-ta'nu fil wulat, criticizing and calling names to the leaders on the manabir, on the pulpit. It falls under nu' min al-khuruj. It is not permissible. If the leader has done something wrong and you want to advise him, go and tell him. Go to him and advise him. Because by going and standing in the Friday khutbatul Jum'ah and shouting on the microphone and criticizing him, this is a matter that would lead to what? To get the people angry against the leader and do what? Khuruj. So it's not permissible. It takes the same ruling as it. Muhammad ibn Sirin said, لو كان لي دعوة مستجابة. Muhammad ibn Sirin said, if I had a dua that I knew Allah would accept, one dua. Pay attention to this. Muhammad ibn Sirin said, if I was told that Allah will only accept one of your dua, what is it? And he said, I would make that dua for the leader. I would say, Ya Rabb, ihdi. Allah guide him to the haqq. Why? Because he said that this individual, for Allah to bring him to the haqq, for Allah tabarak wa ta'ala to keep him steadfast, is a benefit for what? The ummah. Naam.
وأن الجهاد ماض منذ بعث الله عز وجل نبيه صلى الله عليه وسلم إلى قيام الساعة مع أولي الأمر من أئمة المسلمين.
The jihad is forever going. Jihad will never stop. The jihad will never stop. وأن الجهاد ماض. The jihad will go on. But the jihad has conditions. What jihad is it? Not everybody who prays salah, is it salah? If you pray dhuhr not at its time and you pray whenever you want, would it be salah? You wanna shurut are needed, conditions are needed. You have to have wudu. The jihad has shurut. It has conditions. When those conditions are met, that jihad is sahih. Are you with me? That jihad is sahih. So the jihad that it's madin that goes on. Nowadays we find jihad with who? With the believers. Hada jihad? Then you talking about jihad. What is it called? Fitna. That is called what? Muslim fighting another Muslim. The jihad is with the disbelievers. It's with who? With the kuffar. It's with the kuffar. With its context, with its evidences, with the conditions met, and with a leader. With a leader. Shaykh al-Islam Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab, rahimahullah, in his Usul al-Iman, he said, وَأَرَى الْجِهَادُ مَاضِيًا. I see that the jihad will forever be on. مَعَ كُلِّ إِمَامٍ. With all the imam. With an imam, you see. بَرًّا كَانَ أَوْ فَاجِرًا. Whether that imam is righteous or whether imam is a fasiq. The imam is a fasiq. وَصَلَاتُ الْجَمَاعَةِ خَلْفَهُمْ جَائِزَةٌ. And the salah is also permissible behind a leader who is a fajr. It's permissible, you can pray. ولذلك, some of the salaf, they used to pray behind some leaders who used to drink khamar. Who were leading the salah whilst they were muskir. They would pray behind him. And when he turns around, he would laugh and say, shall I add any rak'ah to it? You want more rak'ah? And they would look and say, the day you came, every day extra we have. He used to lead fajr 4 rak'ah. Fajr 4, 3 rak'ah. He said, you want more? And they would still pray behind him. But what did they do first? They first of all prayed at home their salah, and then when they, not to show any disunity. Imam Ahmed said in the Aqidah narrated by Abu Bakr al-Khalal, rahimahullah, he said, وَالْجِهَادُ مَاضٍ قَائِمٌ مَعَ الْأَئِمَّةِ. Again, all the time, the leaders, the ulama, they keep saying what? With the leader. There's no jihad that I just run around by myself. They're with who? مَعَ الْأَئِمَّةِ. With an imam who's controlling it. بَرُّوا أَوْ فَجَرُوا. Whether they are righteous or whether they are transgressors. لَا يُبْطِلُهُ جَوْرُهُ جَائِرٌ. لا يبطل جور جائر ولا عدل عادل. The transgression of his transgression doesn't nullify it, and the righteousness of a righteous one doesn't also nullify it. Wherever he is, it doesn't matter. The jihad is ماضٍ إلى قيام الساعة. نعم.
قوله والحج كذلك.
Hajj is also the same. It means كذلك means what? أي والحج ماضٍ. The Hajj is also forever going to be. أهل السنة they believe that. Hajj doesn't stop. And the Hajj is with who? It's with the leader as well. With the leader who is a fajr. We do Hajj with him. We do Hajj with him. Whether he's a fasiq, whether he's a fajr, we don't look and say, you're gonna take us on a Hajj tour? You? La. Ibn Qudama mentioned in his kitab Al-Lum'atu Al-I'tiqad, وَنَرَى الْحَجَّ وَالْجِهَادَ مَاضِيَيْنِ مَعَ طَاعَةِ كُلِّ إِمَامٍ بَرًّا كَانَ أَوْ فَاجِرًا. Al-Imam al-Barbahari said the same. في شرح السنة والحج والغزو مع الإمام ماض. All of them they say that the Hajj and the Jihad, both of them are forever going to be with the Imam, whether he is what? He is a fasiq or a bar or a fajr. The Hajj and the Jihad, they are both with the Imam. We will do it with him. We will fight with him. نعم.
ودفع الصدقات من السوائم إلى أولي الأمر من أئمة المسلمين.
We also give the what? ودفع الصدقات. We give the صدقات من السوائم. سوائم are the animals which are released. They are freed. They are دواب which are مرسلة. They are made places for it. They eat from those places. They are basically the zakat. They're the cattle that are collected for the zakat. They need somebody to eat, right? We give it to this imam. We give it to him. إِلَىٰ أُولِي الْأَمْرِ مِنْ أَيْمَةِ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. We know this individual plays with the money. He does whatever he wants. He doesn't give the sadaqah to the fuqara if he wants to. He keeps it for himself. He only looks after his family. Whatever the case may be. Is he still a Muslim? He has left Islam, right? Give it to him. You have to give it. As for what he does with it, فَبَيْنَهُ وَبَيْنَ اللَّهِ. It's between him and who? أَلَّا اللَّهُ تَبَارَكُ وَتَعَالَى. وَلِذَلِكَ the message is said in the hadith, أَدُّوا مَا عَلَيْكُمْ. Establish what is yours. Re-establish the rights that he has on you. وَاسْأَلُ اللَّهَ حَقَّكُمْ. And ask Allah your own rights. As for the rights of yours that he oppressed you and he's not giving to you, ask Allah the day of judgment. يَا رَبِّ he took my haqq from me. The day of judgment. As for him, like it, the rights that he has on you, give it to him. And Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal said, وَدَفْعُ الصَّدَقَاتِ إِلَيْهِمْ جَائِزَةٌ نَافِذَةٌ مَنْ دَفَعَ إِلَيْهِ أَجْزَأَتْ عَنْهُ بَرًّا كَانَ أَوْ فَاجِرًا. Giving the sadaqat to them, it is permissible. It's done. مَنْ دَفَعَ إِلَيْهِمْ. Anyone who gives it to them, the zakat is off your shoulders. You don't have to pay zakat, inshallah, it's sorted. Whether he's barran kana aw fajiran, whether he's righteous or whether he's a transgressor, it doesn't matter. Whether he does with what, whether he does what he should have done with it or not, it doesn't matter. And also, what falls under that is the khira, the fate, the ghanima, the spoils of war, everything. He controls it. Na'am. The Muslims don't; they fulfill it for him. Na'am.
والناس مؤمنون في أحكامهم ومواريثهم ولا ندري ما هم عند الله عز وجل.
Also, والناس مؤمنون. The Muslims, the person is what? He is a mu'min في أحكامهم ومواريثهم. From the ظاهر. From the apparent. The people, we give them what? Anyone says La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah, he gives us the testimony of La ilaha illallah. What do we say for them? We Islam Muslim. To us, you say shahadatain, right? You pay the salah. You do what the Muslim. We treat you like a Muslim. Also, the ahkam al muwarith, the ahkam of the inheritance. Your family inherit you. Na'am. We give you the na'am. But we can't say that you're a kafir. A matter which we think is us in your heart. No, in your heart, we think you've got something in it. Nah, I mean, this man doesn't look Muslim. We judge you by what? Also, we can't judge person by what? Just because we've given you a Islam from the apparent, and that we've said that you're a Muslim from the zahir, and that your children inherit you, and that doesn't mean we mean that you're Ahlul Jannah. No, not at all. And we also are not saying you're Ahlul Nar at all. All of that is by who? It is Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala. It is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who does that. Our job is the zahir and the apparent that we see from you. ولذلك الإمام ابن بحري إن شرح السنة he said وأمة محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم فيها أي في الدنيا مؤمنون مسلمون في أحكامهم ومواريثهم وذبائحهم والصلاة عليهم. That the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said that the Ummah of Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم in this dunya, they are Muslims in their ruling towards one another, in the inheriting, in the slaughters and the prayers. If you've never met a Muslim before, first time you saw him, and he saw Islam and he said, I'm a Muslim, and everything, you cool. You see, he leaves the salah. He also, he's slaughter, you eat it. If he brings you food and invites you, you've never known this person before, you can't say, show me your kitchen, I want to see how things are done. No, you judge a person by what? We judge a person. Na'am. And if the person, we don't know, from the zahir, we don't see the opposite holds true. From the zahir, you don't see like Muslim. You take hukm al-kuffar, such as those who worship graves. Those who worship the graves, who are doing major shirk, to us they're kuffar. To us, anyone who worships a shrine, who's sitting by a qabr and he's doing sujood for it, or he's doing a dua to other than Allah, to us, kafirun billahi al-aliyyil azim. He is a kafir. Hukm al-zahir, the apparent is kufr. You fell into what? Shirk al-akbar, right? As for if you're truly a kafir from within, you might have udhrul jahl. You might have the excuse of ignorance. هذا بينك وبين الله. That's between you and Allah. لكن we are ordered to what? أن نحكمك بالظاهر. We're going to judge you by the apparent. From the ظاهر, you're a kafir. Anyone who does a major shirk, and you see him prostrating to an idol, or you see him begging to a grave, he is a kafir. على الظاهر. From the ظاهر. نعم. As for jahl, ignorance, that is for him and Allah the day of judgment. It could be an excuse for him the day of judgment. It could be. Na'am. But in this dunya, we judge people by the apparent. We judge the people by the apparent. Na'am.
فَمَنْ قَالَ إِنَّهُ مُؤْمِنٌ حَقًّا فَهُوَ مُبْتَدِعٌ وَمَنْ قَالَ هُوَ مُؤْمِنٌ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ فَهُوَ مِنَ الْكَاذِبِينَ وَمَنْ قَالَ هُوَ مُؤْمِنٌ بِاللَّهِ حَقًّا فَهُوَ مُصِيبٌ.
The statement that the Shaykh here says, Abu Zur'a and Abi Hatim, the Aqidah here point that's mentioned here right now, is a bit, it has mulahada, especially the third part. Which is what? The author mentions something in the three points that he says. Mm-hmm. The first one he says, إِنَّهُمْ مُؤْمِنٌ حَقًّا فَهُوَ مُبْتَدَعٌ. Anyone who says, I'm a mu'min حَقًّا, he's a mubtada'. And then after that he said, وَمَنْ قَالَ هُوَ مُؤْمِنُ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ فَمِنَ الْكَاذِبِينَ. He's from the liars. And then the third one he said, وَمَنْ قَالَ هُوَ مُؤْمِنُ بِاللَّهِ حَقًّا فَهُوَ مُصِيبٌ. Isn't that the same what he just said at the first faqara? It's the same thing. This issue goes back to عَلَى كُلِّ حَالٍ. عَلَى كُلِّ حَالٍ, this issue goes back to, which is that when a person says, I'm a mu'min, it is aqidat Ahli Sunnati wal Jama'ah to do istithna. Istithna means what? I'm a mu'minun, insha'Allah. I am a mu'min, insha'Allah. Or he says, arju anni mu'minun. I hope that I'm a mu'min. Why? Tajannuban li taskiyatil insani nafsa. Staying away from being one who is what? Who does taskiyah of himself. Taskiyah of him? Of himself. And this is something which is well documented in the books of Aqa'id. The Ahlul Sunnah always speak about. And is it permissible for a person, if he knows that his iman is low, if his iman is low, is he allowed to say that my iman is low? Is it something he can do? Na'am, he can do, based on the hadith of Hanzala. Hanzala, when he said to Abu Bakr, na'am, he said to Abu Bakr that when we're with the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he talks to us about the hereafter, hatta ka'annaha ra'ya aynin. It's like we can see Jannah with our own eyes, our iman increases. فَإِذَا خَرَجْنَا عَاصَفْنَا الزَّوْجَاتِ But he said, when we go home and we spend time with our wives, you see, and we play with them, وَلَعَبْنَا الْأَوْلَادِ And we play with our children, وَبَاشَرْنَا الضَّيْعَاتِ He said, فَيَنْقُسُ مَا عِنْدَنَا مِنَ الْإِيمَانِ Our iman decreases. Our iman increases. You see, and then along famous hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, he said, يَا حَنْضَلَا لَوْ كُنْتُمْ عَلَى الْحَالِ الَّتِي تَكُونُونَ عَلَيْهَا عِنْدِي لَصَافَحْتُكُمُ الْمَلَائِكَةَ فِي طُرُقِكُمْ وَعَلَى فُرُشِكُمْ وَلَكِنْ سَاعَ وَسَاعَ يَا حَنْضَلَا The Prophet ﷺ said, يَا حَنْضَلَا If you guys were the way you were in the, when you're with me, if you were like that every place, then the angels will come down and they would shake your hands in the road and they would shake your hands in your beds. لَكِنْ حَنْضَلَا Sa'a. Sometimes na'am, the person plays and he jokes. Na'am. So it is permissible for the Muslim to talk about his iman. And it's also permissible for the person to say, Ana mu'min. He can say that if he wants to. He can say, Ana mu'minun, I'm a mu'min. He can say that. But what is more befitting is that he brings the istithna and he says, Insha'Allah. So why does he say that? Hatta la yakunu mudda'iyan li kamalil iman. So he doesn't become one who, when he says, Ana, I'm mu'min, then it looks like he means, my iman is complete. My iman is complete. It's better so he doesn't seem like that. Na'am.
وَالْمُرْجِعَةُ مُبْتَدِعَةٌ ضُلَّالٌ
The murji'a are an innovated, misguided group. What are the murji'a? وَالْمُرْجِعَةُ The murji'a are مُبْتَدِعَةٌ They are innovators. ضُلَّالٌ Misguided individuals. What does murji'a mean? What does that word murji'a mean? Or what meaning does it have? Murji'a means الَّذِينَ أَرْجَعُوا الْأَعْمَالَ وَأَخَرُوهَا عَنْ إِسْمِ الْإِيمَانِ The word irja means it is to delay and it's to take out the iman, the actions out of iman. That's what the word irja means. That is what irja means. That they've actually taken out the iman, they've taken it out of what? Sorry, they took out actions out of iman. They took the actions out of iman. And based on their belief, they said, لا يضر مع الإيمان ذنبود. Any sin that you do, it will not harm what? It will not harm, any sin that you do will not harm your iman. That's no problem. That's what they said. And they said the same way is, the opposite holds truth. The argument was when they said that, any sin that you do, that it won't harm your iman, they said, doesn't the opposite hold truth? Which is, they said, كَمَا لَا يَنْفَكُّ مَعَ الْكُفْرِ طَاعَ What about if a person is a kafir and he does obedience? Will it benefit him? No. So they said the same is when a person is a believer and he does a sin, it won't harm him. That's what they said. And they went against Ahlul Sunnah regarding this issue, which is that the iman has branches and it has levels. They went against Ahlul Sunnah. So, وَالْمُرْجِئَةُ مُبْتَدِعَةٌ ضُلَّالٌ They are ضُلَّالٌ And a lot of Muslims fall into this issue. They say, أخي, he said, لا إله إلا الله. Akhi said, La ilaha illallah. Or Akhi said, La ilaha illallah, but he came with nawaqid al-Islam. He came with matters that nullify his Islam. And you're still holding him into Islam. You're still bringing it in. When he's clearly said, Kalimatu kufrin. Or when this person is worshipping idols. Or he's doing kufriyat, which are clear cut. Na'am, holding him into Islam. Saying that he can't be, and La ilaha illallah, that just that word by itself. And there's nothing that can take him out of Islam. Then that's murji'atu. That's the belief of the murji'ah. Na'am.
والقدرية مبتدعات ضلال.
The Qadariyya, they are مبتدعات. And they are ضلال, misguided. And the Qadariyyin are two types. القدرية ينقسمون إلى قسمين. They are divided into two. قدرية نفات وقدرية مثبتة أما قدرية غلات. As some say. Who are they? The قدرية النفات are the ones who negate. They negate what? They negate from the person any form of choice. They say that the person doesn't have no choice. No, sorry. The Qadariyyatun Nufat, they negate from Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala ability. They say Allah is not able to do what? That Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala is not able to what? Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala is not able to creed for a person kufr. Allah can't do that, they said. And Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala is not able to do fisq. He can't do that. We love Allah. How can we say Allah, he destined and he writ and he wanted evil? Kufr. No. And we don't believe Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala fisq and fawahish. All of these are actions of the creation. They have the ability. Allah doesn't. Na'am. Allah doesn't. And they also negated from Allah knowledge. And they said Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala also doesn't even know until it happens. After it happens, Allah finds out later that this person has fallen into kufr. Because we don't want Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala to have been aware of all of this and let the person be. We don't want to affirm that to Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala. They are called qadariyyatun nufat. They negated from Allah. The second group are called the Qadariyyatul Ghullat. Ama Qadariyyatu Al Mujbira. The Qadariyyatul Mujbira are the opposites. They said the servant doesn't have anything now. Allah has everything. The control is all in Allah's hands. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. And what have they said? That the creation has no ability. We don't have any ability. And this is called Tasarruf Qahri. Allah has forcefully controlled us. He does whatever He wants to us. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. And He fulfills whatever things He wants from us. Like we are like a leaf on a windy day. The wind just takes us wherever, Allah takes us wherever. When you see this person commit zina, say, SubhanAllah, Allah did this to him. He's not him. When he's doing zina, it's not him. Na'am. That's what they believe. That's what they believe. Al-Sunnah refuted them. And Al-Sunnah refuted them by those points that we mentioned before when we were talking about Maratibul Qadr. If the person affirms those four levels of Qadr, he will go out of it. We said it's knowledge, that everything Allah knows it, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Everything Allah created it. Everything is connected to Allah's will. And finally, everything Allah tabarak wa ta'ala writ it. Everything Allah writ it. And also Al-Sunnah said that the Qadr is two types. Al-Qadr, which is matters pertaining to the universe, which is Qadr, which is Kawniyya, universal issues. The universal issues, you see, it's all what? That which Allah loves and that which Allah hates. Universally, Allah creates that which He likes and that which He doesn't like, subhanahu wa ta'ala. You see, Allah creates a believer and a disbeliever. Allah created Iblis and Allah tabarak wa ta'ala created the angels, universally. Lakin in the Sharia, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He only wills that which is good. And He said in the ayah, وَلَا يَرْضَى لِعِبَادِهِ الْكُفْرِ. Allah is not pleased for His creation, what? Kufr. Displeasement here is what? What does it mean? Displeasing here is qadariyan, qadaran. Shar'i. Like in Conan, na'am. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, if He didn't will it, it would not have happened, would it? University Conan. Like in Shar'an, what? Allah doesn't like kufr. Shar'an. Conan, university, like in, does Allah want kufr? If He didn't want it, then it would not have happened. If He didn't want it, it would not have happened. And we spoke about this issue in details elsewhere. Na'am. And we will, inshallah ta'ala, speak about it in more details now, inshallah ta'ala, in the next point. A bit of more points, inshallah ta'ala. Now.
وَمَنْ أَنْكَرَ مِنْهُمْ أَنَّ اللَّهَ يَعْلَمُ مَا يَكُونُ قَبْلَ أَنْ يَكُونَ فَهُوَ كَافِرٌ.
The author then he says, وَمَنْ أَنْكَرَ anyone, this is عِلْمُ اللَّهِ سَابِقٌ. This issue is based on Allah's things that are going to happen. Allah's knowledge regarding it. Anyone who negates, وَمَنْ أَنْكَرَ مِنْهُمْ, anyone who negates, أَنَّ اللَّهَ يَعْلَمُ, that Allah تبارك وتعالى knows, مَا يَكُونُ, that which is going to happen, قَبْلَ أَنْ يَكُونَ, before it takes place, فَوَ كَافِرٌ. He negates it. He doesn't believe it. That person is a kafir. Kafir. Because we know Allah تبارك وتعالى has knowledge of everything. علم الله تبارك وتعالى بتقدير المقادر مقادير. Everything Allah has destined it. How it's going to be. Days in, day out, Allah has destined it. Not only that, it's written for him.